Hey guys, Snap My Gamer back here from the video. Guys, today I'm going to give you the most dummied down offense you're ever going to run in Madden. Now, if you suck at offense, this video is for you, okay? You guys know I ran this offense for 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Main reason why is because it's the most dummy down offense. You can literally have the easiest reads possible, get down the field, get tutties, so simply. It is not a complicated offensive run. It all comes out of gun split close pats. This isn't the Patriots playbook. No other playbook. This formation is not gun split close. It's gun split close pats. Keep that in mind. So I'm going to show you some one play tutties, some simple reads, some simple plays to run, and then we're going to talk about some run plays, all that kind of great concepts. So starting off right away, we're going to talk about X drag trail. If you guys see my videos, you guys know I always come in X drag trail. I always come out in it because I love it so freaking much. So simply what we're going to do is motion over the running back right here to the left hand side, and this is the simple list play art you're going to see. Now your first read on this play is going to be the X route on the drag route right here underneath. Go ahead and hike the ball. You can see he gets wide open every single time. Cover two, cover three, it does not matter. If they run man coverage, most of the time he gets bumped off his guy and he's wide open every single time. Again, it is free money. Now the second read you're going to make is your tight end on this play. Now it's going to take a little bit longer for the tight end to get open, and you guys are going to see that as I get destroyed right there by my no offensive line, I'm actually going to go ahead and have that tight end get wide open on that left hand side. So around the 40 yard line is where you're looking for this tight end to be open on this play, and he's going to get open every single time. You guys have seen my videos, you guys know I literally abuse this so freaking much. Now I am running this against cover two. Against cover three, it's a 99.9% success rate. Against cover two, it can be a little bit less just because that cloud flat can play a little bit better, and if they do have zone drops on, then they're going to be even better than that. But 99% of the time, most people don't know what zone drops are, so it's going to be a free money play to run against pretty much anybody. If they do run cover two though, you're gonna want to go through and hit the drag route. Once they switch to cover three, that's when you're gonna see this play work a lot more to the tight end on this play. But again, like I said, you guys can see how the cloud flat is playing that very nicely. And again, let's go ahead and switch over to cover three real fast just to show you how effective it is against cover three. I just want to come out in cover two to show you that drag route is pretty much money if they do come out in cover two. Now if they come out in cover three and they're like, hey, I'm gonna come out in cover three on the play, it's not a big deal. That's actually when the tight end route gets wide open. So hike the ball, and like I said here, we're gonna look for that tight end route. It's gonna get literally booty butthole naked down the field. It's gonna be a guaranteed 10, 15, 20 yards, even more depending on who your tight end is. A lot of time I like to go ahead and put a receiver in this route, in this play, because it makes it even more glitchy. Now the halfback, you can target the halfback on these plays. I just recommend not doing it, and the reason why is because that halfback, although he is really good, he just simply is a distraction. The only time I ever target the running back is if I'm motioning, if I'm rolling out to my left-hand side like this, and then I see the, you know, halfback go across the middle here, and then I look toward that type of concept. That's the only time I look at the halfback. I don't really look at him at all. Again, like I said, he's more of a distraction. My main reads on this play against cover two is going to be the X. Against cover three is going to be the tight end across the left-hand side here. That's going to be my two reads on the play. I'm not really looking at the halfback at all, but that's the simplest reads out of this play. Now let's go ahead and change this play a tad bit. What we're going to do is go ahead and motion over hill, and we're going to put him on a fade route. Next thing we're going to do, guys, we're going to go ahead and block the right running back and put our Le'Veon Bell on an out. And this is the same concept we just ran, but a little bit different. So we can still look for that tight end route right here. Bam, go ahead and possession that and get down the field. But at the same time though, what I do like to run on this play and why I like this concept is you're able to go ahead and actually throw the ball out of the backfield or run that drag route right there, simply as can be, as my eye is just completely dying on the play. So right here, you can see the halfback gets a little bit of a bump and he's able to go ahead and get a couple extra yards. Most of the time, again, like I said, you're going to get 4, 5, 6 yards on the halfback play. Drag route, again, isn't always guaranteed to get probably 8, 9 yards, even more depending on who you have on that drag route. But you guys can see right here, bam, that tight end is so money on this play because he drags the guy over and takes him out of the play, which allows the drag route to get wide open. So next concept is going to be the one play tutty. So first one play tutty we have is going to go ahead and be out of Y out. Now, if you guys seen live streams, you guys know I've run this so many freaking times against people, and it is literally free money. A lot of times I have Steve Smith on this play running this, but you can run this also with, you know, whoever you have. You just want to have the fastest guy possible at that X receiver role. So once I hike the ball, what we're looking for is that X receiver here, and you guys are going to see, bam, that is free, absolute money, money back guaranteed. Celebrate on a Mecole Hardman because it is a one play tutty pretty much every single time. If you are on the wide side of the field, this right side of the field, the hash marks, this is a free tutty. If you're on the left side of the field, it will work, but it will be a little bit more difficult to run just because, again, it's a closer side of the field if you're going to run on that side of the field. So what I recommend doing is running the ball to the right-hand side, getting to the right hash marks, and this is going to be a one-play tutty, and you're going to be celebrating like crazy because you're going to be getting one-play tutties. Now, we have one more one-play tutty we'll be looking at in this video, and you guys are going to see it is even glitchier than this one just because there's so many other routes in the field you can run. But let's go ahead and go back to a wide trail. So again, like I said, you know, we're talking about wide trail, we're talking about this play. There's so many different things to run out of the X drag trail that we're even going to talk about even more. So first off, this is a one play tutty out of this form, this exact play. So again, you can run one play, just change it up so many different ways that your opponent does not know what he's doing. So first off, we're going to go ahead and streak our tight end Kelce, and we're looking on this play for Tyreek Hill. And you guys are going to see, again, this is not a guaranteed. The reason why I showed you the other one, you know, first, and now I'm showing you this one, is because this is not guaranteed. This one is very, if I won't say it's not iffy, it's just sometimes it works, sometimes it won't. It's a more of a 60-40 type of split. It all depends on what that safety does right there. As you guys saw, that safety, he went ahead and actually played it very well, but not, I'll say 60% of the time, what he'll do is he'll end up dropping on this play. He'll end up dropping to cover. He'll end up dropping to cover that halfback out of the backfield. And when he drops to cover that halfback, that's when that play gets wide open. So I'm going to go ahead and run this again. Like I said, it's not 100% of the time, but there is times where it will work. It's just you need to wait for that safety to drop. And depending on what coverage they come out in, like I said, it will change a lot. That last one play tutty is almost 100% of the time you're going to get a one play tutty. As long as you're on the wide side of the field here, you're going to be fine. But there are times where you're just simply, it's just not going to work because of the fact that the safety is playing that very well. So again, this one play tutty, not 100% of the time, but it will work a lot of the time. So now let's go ahead and talk about halfback wheel, because we have not even covered the main play I love to run so many times. And there's even more stuff to talk about halfback wheel, guys. If you guys want to see another video of this, make sure you tell me down below, because I will go ahead and continue to make more videos about this. But first off, what you want on a halfback wheel is going to go ahead and drag route, slant the, okay, that's slant, sorry, what do you call that? It's called a drag route. I'm so stupid. Drag route B. All you're going to do here is going to motion over Le'Veon Bell. I like to put him also on a drag route. The reason why I like to run this concept, you're going to hike the ball. Bam. You can literally destroy the user. Like, you can make the user want to go home and quit Madden, because all you're doing here is the simplest concept. You're just going to go ahead and simply drag routes. Easy as pie. Now, this is the reads for this play, okay? Halfback out of the backfield. If that guy on the right-hand side is not covering the running back, if he's not shading underneath, you're going to throw to the running back out of the backfield. If he is shading underneath and he's covering that running back, maybe the user is covering that running back, you're going to go ahead and throw to one of the drag routes. If he starts pressing you like crazy, and you say, you know, I'm just going to press this guy, and I'm going to beat him by pressing him so that both drag routes are covered and the underneath route, well, guess what we're going to run here? And we're going to have some time to run this, but we're going to go down the field here. Now, again, the safety is playing very good. Passage mode, what I think I'm learning about passage mode is freaking broken when it comes to being glitchy sometimes. 90% of the time, what you see in practice mode is not going to happen in real game. Like, and that could be a negative thing and a positive thing. But anyway, though, the whole concept is, if that doesn't work and he starts pressing you, we're looking deep on this play down the field to that X receiver on that right-hand side. Because if he starts pressing you, the safeties are going to be playing in the box, which allows your guys to get wide open deeper down the field. And again, you can always hit this tight end. If he starts shading underneath here, hit this tight end on the right-hand side, because that cloud flat that was covering that tight end on that seam route is no longer going to be covering it. So, again, like I said, just simple reads, drag routes, and underneath route, halfback route. If he's giving you it, take what you can get. If he is shading underneath, tight end route. If he is pressing you, X route. That's your simple reads. And again, if you come out cover two, cover three, it does not matter. Same concept applies every single time. Now, another concept you can run again with this exact same play is go ahead and motion out Carlos Edwards-Helaire. I kind of learned this the other day without even realizing it. Go ahead and streak Carlos Edwards-Helaire here, right? You're going to go ahead and put Tyreek Hill on a slant route. What you're going to see on this play, you can even go ahead and put Mecole Hardman on a streak here. But what we're going to see is Tyreek Hill gets wide open pretty much every single time. Well, this play, he didn't get wide open. I don't know why. Yeah, that's kind of surprising to get wide open. He always get wide open against pretty much every single coverage. I'm not sure if the CPU is shading over top or shading underneath here. But pretty much what happens here, guys, is, like I said, is that because you're going ahead and doing this, let me keep it how it was, actually. Yeah, let me keep that how it was. And again, that's weird. That's actually really weird, because 100% of the time online, he gets wide open every single time. The CPU is just playing that really, really good. But the whole concept here, guys, is allowing, let's actually put him on a drag route. It probably would work out a lot better if we put him on a drag route here. But again, like I said, the whole point is that left side of the field is going to go and be wide open, because that deeper X route takes over and makes that wide side of the field get wide open. And because it's so congested over here, it messes with the whole entire AI logic. Bam, wide open, free money, free yards, just like that. Pretty easy concept. Let's talk about some run plays out of this system, out of the scheme. So that your run plays, you have a couple run plays to run. First off, you have single back ace, which I love because you have halfback stretch. You guys already know halfback stretch, okay? Halfback stretch is broken, man. Halfback stretch is broken. Pretty much, if you guys are not new to halfback stretch, it is a best run formation in the game. It's the best run play in the game. It's not as OP as it used to be, but pretty much plain simple. Just follow your blockers, find the hole, hit the hole, and you can get one play tutty very, very easy in halfback stretch. It is not a hard concept to run. It's not a hard play to run. It is a very easy concept to run. Pretty much every single time you get 5-6 yards. CPU will be OP, but keep that in mind. All right, next run play I like out of this is going to go ahead and be in the formation, and it's going to go ahead and be, I'm about to check this out here. I already went through it. I'm just making sure I don't like any other run plays here. Here we go. Inside zone at a gun strip tight end flex. So this play right here, this inside zone is my absolute favorite inside zone. Main reason why is because you can literally switch to a verticals play here. Go ahead and go back to your crossers play, or you can go to this halfback play. And again, you can see right here, it is a read option play, which means that it's going to be very hard for the opponent to know what you're running. If you're running the crosses play, you're running the play action play. The same concept, you can run, you can go ahead and run the ball, then bam, they think you're going to run the ball again. You hit them on the crossing route down the field, easy money. It's a real good trickeroo to say, hey, I'm going to run the ball, hey, I'm going to pass the ball. You never know, your opponent doesn't know. Absolute golden. Other than that, I think that is all it is for this initial setup for this scheme. A halfback draw is another play to run that I do really like. And how you set this up, pretty much, you go ahead and take Tyreek Hill right here, motion him to the left-hand side, and before he goes ahead and gets set, you're going to go ahead and then hike the ball. The reason why is because he will go straight toward the closest defender, block that defender, and you get a little bit better of a guy, another extra blocker in there that lets you be able to actually, you know, get a little bit more blocking. Now, if you're going to do this, find someone who's big and strong. Tyreek Hill's not really big and strong, but find someone more big and strong. Same concept again. Let's go ahead and run it one more time. Motion over. Hike the ball. He finds his guy. Bam. Guys, if you did enjoy this video, hit the like, hit the subscribe button down below. Tell me down below, guys, you want to see more in-depth. We can even go more into this playbook because, again, I read this for so freaking long. It's only part one of this scheme. So if you guys want to see more of this scheme, tell me down below, guys. I'll see you guys in the next one.